Pittsburgh Penguins in action again tonight. Second of a back-to-back, back at home, taking on the Minnesota Wild, who were sitting there comfortably in Pittsburgh last night, watching the Pens and Caps slug it out. You can see a season comparison between the two teams. And to preview that one, who else but our old friend, the play-by-play voice of the Pittsburgh Penguins, Mr. Steve Mears. Mearsy, welcome to the show once again. And let's talk about last night's game, because I'm sure you were watching it with right on the edge of your seat. What were some of your takeaways from the game between the Caps and the Pens last night?
Hard, hard-fought battle, the Penguins and the Caps, as usual. And I give the Penguins full credit for grinding out a 2-1 win. Starts with the goaltender, just as Mike Sullivan said. Matt Murray was spectacular, his second game back from the lower body injury. So he's 2-0 now since the return. And sure, a rivalry game, and a game against your biggest rival, just what the Penguins needed to get a little extra fuel. And they had it last night, between the shot blocks, the heavy minutes from Chris Letang, diving effort by Marcus Pettersson to save a goal. Riley Sheahan right on the goal line, two picked up a loose puck after it hit the post, and most importantly, the goaltending of Matt Murray, and of course, led by Sidney Crosby. Full marks to the Penguins for finding a way to win against a red-hot Washington Capitals team. I think that's the type of game we've been waiting for from the Penguins against a quality opponent, and it does remind us that they have that ability to turn it up when they have to, and they certainly did last night in hostile territory in Washington. They get a 2-1 win.
Mears, you touched on Marcus Pettersson really quickly. Great play to sweep the puck off the blue line, or the goal line. But beyond that, it was kind of an underrated pickup, maybe one of those ones that most people don't pay attention to. How has he been working out so far in Pittsburgh beyond the goal line saves?
Yeah, that's like the highlight, eye-opening play, and maybe his welcome to Pittsburgh moment now. But he's been really solid for the time that he's been here, now 9 games or so. I think he's been really smooth. A good first pass, long reach. He's now the youngest player on the Penguins at age 22. And I think defensively, he's been solid. The Penguins had been trying to find some different combinations, trying to get a steady flow on the blue line, and it wasn't really working out. They had players coming in and out of the lineup, and now all of a sudden they pick up Marcus Pettersson. Did go up a lot in the form of Daniel Sprong, but they pick up Marcus Pettersson, and he has solidified and stabilized the Penguins' defense. He's paired out with Jack Johnson, reliable veteran there on the blue line. And, of course, you have Letang and Dumoulin as a number one pair, but for a second pair, Pettersson and Johnson, they've been pretty good.
Mearsy, we want to get to some of the other Metro teams, but I do want to follow up on one thing about the Pens when we look forward to tonight's game. Are you worried at all that it's just a little bit of a letdown game tonight? They've had trouble with Minnesota in the past. It's a non-conference opponent. Is there a concern that, you know, they left a lot on the table last night, now they got to come back in and play Minnesota tonight?
Yes, absolutely. You think about, it reminds me of my Islander days, and they had the Ranger hangover after an Islander-Ranger game. The next game was usually a loss for the Islanders. I remember that phrase. I think also just the physical toll that the game took last night. I mean, you had obviously Oleksiak getting injured, and we'll find out about his status and a couple of other players here in a little while when we speak with Mike Sullivan. But just, it was a hard, hard-fought battle with so many shot blocks. Brian Rust was shaken up. Chris Letang played over 32 minutes, his season high, and one of the highest totals for any player in the NHL this season. And those 32 minutes, those were hard-fought minutes against Alex Ovechkin. Penguins also had to penalty kill 5 times, block shots, physical game against a bigger Washington team. So there's no question about it. I think just from the physical toll of last night's game, and then just the human nature aspect of going up against your biggest rival and now in a back-to-back against a Minnesota team, as you said, Western Conference opponent, team we don't see all that often, and the fact they were here in Pittsburgh waiting for us, I think it's going to make for a really difficult challenge. And the Penguins have played a lot of hockey lately, 6 games in 9 nights, a lot of games crammed into these last 2 weeks before the holiday break. So, yeah, absolutely. I agree with what you said. It is going to be a really difficult game here tonight against a Minnesota team that got blanked in their last game against San Jose.
All right, Mearsy, let's just take a little trip around the Metro. You see these teams, you call them on a nightly basis. We'll start with the team in second place. You played the first place Capitals last night. Columbus Blue Jackets right now, they're just 1 point ahead of the teams chasing them, the Islanders and the Penguins. What do you make of their season so far? How are they looking right now?
Yeah, we saw them once earlier in the season, and of course there's another team, big rival of the Penguins. I think everything, no matter what the analysis is, no matter what you say about Columbus, it circles around the Bobrovsky-Panarin situation. I mean, that has to be rectified. And I think just learn the lesson of the New York Islanders and the John Tavares situation from last year. You've got to have a deadline. You've got to have a clear-cut vision of what those two players are going to do. And if they are not in the long-term plans, you have to move them. I mean, learn the lesson of the Islanders and Tavares from last year. But I'm a huge fan of Seth Jones and what he's been doing this season with the huge minutes, at times leading the league in ice time. He's certainly been in the top three right up there with Drew Doughty and Chris Letang. Need to get Zach Werenski back to that all-star form. But you like the pieces there in Columbus. But no matter what I say or what anybody says, it all comes down to Bobrovsky and Panarin for me.
All right, how about the Islanders? They've had a nice start to the season. They've won a couple games in a row now on the road. Where do they fit in?
Very impressive. We're done with the Islanders this year. Played them four times, including the most recent one, which was in the Coliseum. It was great going back there, and a shootout win for the Penguins. I think everybody, Mike Sullivan and a lot of the Penguins players, talked about structure with the Islanders. Defensive structure, they're much better defensively in general under Barry Trotz. And how about the goaltending? I mean, the most improved players, some of the most improved players, Thomas Greiss, Robin Leonard's been pretty solid. Even you look at Yaroslav Halak and what he's doing now in Boston as compared to last year with the Islanders. So most important, the goaltending with the Islanders, and a much better defensive team. We saw Thomas Greiss in Brooklyn, and that was the best opposing goaltending performance that the Penguins have faced all season long. He stood on his head. He was the main reason, maybe the only reason, why they were able to steal 2 points in a thrilling game at Barclays Center. So very impressed with Thomas Greiss, a former Penguin, and overall, Matt Barzal, Josh Bailey. There are some pieces there, I think, for a playoff team. Maybe not a Stanley Cup contender, but definitely a playoff contender.
And Mirzi, lastly, what about the Rangers? Henrik Lundqvist is still going strong. They're kind of stuck in between. They're supposed to be younger, but they're still kind of competing. What do you think of them?
Yeah, that's one team we have not seen yet, but I'm looking forward to those matchups because the Penguins this year have had some difficulty against some of these younger, faster teams. So, yeah, very curious to see what the Rangers are going to do. We are going to see them on January 2nd as part of the end of a three-game road trip, but I love the vision. And look around the league. Montreal, Vancouver, Ottawa. We've seen a lot of those teams here this season. That's the direction, younger, faster. That's the go-to phrase. And the Rangers, they made it very clear what their vision was, what the plan was going to be. And it's not like the old days where it takes 5, 6, 7 years to rebuild. We're seeing it now firsthand. You can get things turned around pretty quickly as long as you're not stuck in mediocrity right there, maybe 9th, 10th, year after year. And that's where you get into some trouble. But as you said, with Henrik Lundqvist, still one of the best goaltenders, you have the foundation right there. And clearly the vision is younger, faster, going along with the trend of the rest of the National Hockey League. And I've been really impressed with what I've seen. Can't wait to see what the Penguins and Rangers have in store. 4 games still on the regular season schedule.
All right, Mirzi. That's it, buddy. It's over.
Great talking to a fellow Bowling Green alum.
We're done.
Keep up the good work. You're flying like our alma mater.
I know.
Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah.
I was so happy to make EJ's Christmas album the other day.
Yes,
I tuned in for like 5 minutes, and there was EJ's Christmas album. Yep. You forgot a couple of songs, though. I think there was one. It's beginning to look a lot like Luffman.
One of my favorites.
And Rocking Around the Say Hey Cafe. That's another one.
Nicely done.
Very
well done,
Mr. Mears. Which is a classic, I know.
Yeah, that's
also a classic.
Treat.
You can't forget about those.
All right. No receipt for you, buddy. No receipt. Have a
that's
lovely
right. I don't want one.
Holiday, and we will talk to you soon.